Hello, here are the Matrixers, and with Shiva,
Jonathan, and
and
Gosia from Cosmic Agency.
Hi everybody. Hello Jonathan, hello Shiva, thank you for the invitation.
Hello Gosia, thank you very much to have you here in our talk, and we are not familiar with interviews and talks on video, but we thought in your case we make a special exception because your material, your videos are very interesting, and we have seen a lot of videos now.
Normally we are not watching any videos at all on YouTube or
we have been led to you, so to say. And the first video we have seen was about the cryo pods.
Immersion pods.
And you call them immersion pods. Now we call them cryo pods or cryogenic pods. Don't know the English word for it.
Yeah, cryogenic, yes.
Cryogenic. And very interesting topic. And
We have seen us laying in the cryopods or in the immersion pods many years ago, and then we was led to you and saw the topic of immersion pods, and we were so amazed by it. And yeah, we have also questions. We don't see everything, but we have seen us in the immersion pods, and we love that topic. Immersion pods are so special because a lot of starseeds are laying in this immersion pods, coming to Earth, to help Earth or people on Earth. Yeah,
we have not such a direct contact to arrive with extraterrestrials. That's interesting that you are not channeling extraterrestrial beings, but you have a direct chat contact to them.
Well, that's nice.
That's right.
Yeah. And in this case, we have just our inner abilities we use. We use dreaming and astral travel, hypnagogic stages we use, and we use dissociation to get to the informations. And it's very interesting to see that it's possible to have a direct contact about chatting with extraterrestrials who seem to live in a starship in the orbit of the Earth. Maybe you would like to talk about how you have managed this contact and who they are with them you have a contact.
Yeah, for sure. Yes, they are able to communicate with people through the chat, through the online writing. Not only, but this is how we communicate. Well, because why? Well, because they are people. They are physical people. That's important, because if you are communicating with some entity or a being from another higher density who doesn't necessarily have a form, so that will be more of a telepathic communication with that kind of energetic being. But in this case, they are people. This is something that still causes some type of confusion among some people, because everybody imagines that, you know, the beings outside, 5D creatures, they are some sort of a light beings or, you know, orb angels and things like that. And we do not dismiss the existence of those beings. They do exist. But as they explain to us, that's on a higher density. That's somewhere still higher. But outside Earth, those beings, people that fly the physical ships, are people. And they are Taygetan Pleiadians, and this is the group with whom we communicate, Taygetan Pleiadians. But not only, there are so many extraterrestrial, physical, biological beings and people out there right now in the orbit of the Earth, and not just now, they have always been here. That's why right away I say I hate this term aliens, because it's such a negative associations, and they are just extraterrestrial people. So this is the group that we specifically have been able to communicate with since 2017. I say we because it's me and my work partner, Robert, who is doing this in a Spanish channel. And I also have to stress, it's not just us. There have been actually hundreds of people they communicated with and they tried to communicate with, not anymore, because they were executing the so-called first contact program since 2008 to 2016, where the Federation, Galactic Federation, which is a real organization, another topic, they allowed them to enter the communication with the humans through internet, because this is the technology that is available to us right now, and they limited them to just typing. So they are not allowed to use their voice or video. We can, like, for example, on our side, we can communicate with them by audio and also show video, but they have to respond in writing. We did have several audio experiences with them, but just a few. That was with one of the male Taygetan pilot, Dorkalel. That was a few years ago, but that was kind of like against the rules. I'm not going to go into the details how he achieved this, but it was done. And also with Yaski Svaru, one of our contacts, we also had a short, brief audio conversation, but her voice was a bit distorted because the Federation imposes a lot of limitations on them and on general, protocols of contact with Earth. So long story short, since 2017, we started communicating with them in writing, and it has been going on almost daily, almost, because there are breaks. The last big break was actually 5 months. We didn't hear from them for 5 months. But other than that, it continues every day. And I know it raises the eyebrows of many people. How is it that, you know, you're communicating through the online chat? But, well, they have resorted to this type of communication rather than channeling and telepathy, because they wanted to have a non-distorted and direct contact and communication. So this way, if anybody shares this information, like in our case, we decided to share this. By the way, important, they didn't ask us to share this. We wanted to share this. In this way, what we share is word by word what was said, and they communicate in Spanish or in English, depending on who they're speaking with. And I share these conversations and topics in the videos in my YouTube channel, Cosmic Agency. And I have like over, I don't know, 430 videos or so in just English, where you can see all these communications and information shared on so many different topics. And like you said, the immersions, cryo pods is one of the topics. It fascinates me as well, this topic, because I am in the pod as well. So, and I actually, what's actually interesting is that I felt that something to do with that before I even had this experience. That's why when they shared this, it confirmed to me my own feelings. So I'm pretty sure that a lot of starseeds feel something is not right, something is not completely there. In my case, I felt like not my fullness of me is here. Like I'm actually projecting from somewhere. That was my interpretation of it, like in the movie Matrix, where, you know, you put on some kind of a headphones. I don't know, very simple example, but whatever. You are laying somewhere in a chair, somewhere else, and you were projecting into another avatar. That's how I felt. I felt like I am not really here. I'm projecting from somewhere else. But I didn't understand it until I met them and they gave us this detailed, very detailed technical explanation of how this procedure actually works. And then I understood it and it makes sense. And I'm now much more in peace with this feeling, and it's everything just fell into place. So let me just ask you, because like you said, it's a chat, it's not like a total interview. So for my viewers, I want to say we'll just like have a conversation about this. I want to ask you, like, how did you actually feel yourself in the pod? How was the feeling? How did you know?
started maybe 2016.
Yeah.
So about.
Oh, okay.
And I believe you started to see some pictures.
Yeah, I have hypnagogic states, and in the states, someone above show me pictures, tell me, communicate with me telepathically. And they show me that we are laying in cryopods or immersion pods. And they show me where and what we look like. And it's a huge, very light room, white room, and there are a lot of immersion pods inside. And I have seen us laying there. There was an extraterrestrial people or man, and they said, "That is you," and that is him in the pods. And I thought, okay, what is that? That was my first time ever seeing that. I didn't really know what's that, but it was interesting. That was and then I saw us a lot of time in immersion pods, and I got a lot more information about immersion pods. There are immersion pods just for holidays, and there are pods just for healing, and there are planets they use immersion pods just for a weekend to come here to Earth to spend one lifetime here, and on that planet is just a weekend of like a small holiday, and it's that's funny.
But I didn't understand the very beginning. You said it was like a vision, like you had a telepathic picture of yourself. Okay. Wow. Yeah,
us in the immersion pods. And the man.
And you two, both. Did you, and Jonathan, did you see also yourself in the pod, or is it just...
Yeah, in some dreams and hypnagogic states, the state between waking and sleeping. We call it hypnagogic state. It's from psychology, the term.
And,
I have seen it in hypnagogic state that I am laying in a pot, and I have seen through the glass. It is surrounded with glass, and I have seen through the glass before the program started. And
okay.
I see her next to me in another pod.
So she was in a different body, but you knew that it was her.
Before we started going to Earth, we talk about, should we do go to Earth? It's dangerous. It's difficult to get out of the matrix again, but we need to do that. We need to go to the immersion pods to go to Earth. We had this discussion before the immersion.
Yeah, we had our doubts.
Yeah, I think everybody in some way, they have doubts. Yeah. And it's funny. I mean, it's amazing that you were able to find each other too, because there is this risk. You know, you go to the immersion pod, and especially if your memories there then are not going to be fully activated, then you may never, fully find each other. But at the same time, I do know that there is a plan also, even on a soul level, to rediscover each other here. And something I was And what race then is it?
I don't know. So we think it's Syrian because we are light blue gray.
Okay.
And my voice.
And taller.
Sometimes he is switching in the hypnagogic states from his avatars to this original avatar, and suddenly he is like double
3 meters or so.
Yeah.
Wow, amazing. Syrians, they are beautiful beings.
I think so. Syrian, so I think it's.
Okay. Now, just maybe to explain to you, I don't know how much your viewers know about the immersion pods, but actually the immersion technology is the one that is most commonly used now as the entry way for the extraterrestrials to be humans. And actually, you might ask why do they use the immersion technology? Well, how they explain to us is that it is kind of like a like safeguarding their return, because once you die here, your physical avatar dies, you wake up in the pod, so you return. And if you kind of dare to come in here directly from the source, if you die, for example, as an extraterrestrial, and then you come here from the astral afterlife, then, you know, the matrix is very heavy and it can, you know, lure you into this reincarnation cycle over and over again here on Earth. So if you come as in immersion pods, you are going back to your original body. And like you said, it was just an experience. And someone, for example, asks someone, a lot of people are talking about the soul traps after death. Mm-hmm. And, you know, after you die, there are soul traps. And they told us that there are no soul traps rather than your own mind, your own ideas that are creating this sort of imprisoning, you know, construct that is making you go back. So the point here is that the people who are in the immersion supposedly do have some sort of an extra protection there, that they are kind of returned. They're a signal, because that's what we are. We are just a signal. Our soul is a signal. So it returns to the original pod. So that's why this technology is very used by a lot of extraterrestrials. Cool. Actually, I have a description if your viewers want to know the way my friends from the orbit talk, the way they speak. I actually written down a short description of the immersion pods, and this is how they explain it here. But for the full transcript, oh, by the way, because we also have transcripts on the website, svaru.org. So you don't have to watch all 400 videos. You can just read the transcripts. But this is what they said. Immersions are used for countless purposes. Like you said, entertainment. Entertainment meaning that they are not using them to enter Earth as an incarnation. They are just using it on a ship as a sort of entertainment to enter those pods. There will be like short-term pods, and they can be transferred somehow, you know, to the beach, for example, or to the mountains,
because like we do the VR glasses, huh?
Yes, it's like a high technology virtual reality with all the sensors imposed on your brain, and you really feel like you are there. The difference is that you know what you're doing. And here when they use the immersion pods to come to Earth as humans, and most of the time we don't know, because we lose memory in the process. Mm-hmm. But that's another topic. So anyway, so it can be used for entertainment, teleconferences, like, for example, if they want to communicate with another member of the family or someone on a distant planet. So they
like both Star Wars, enter.
Yes. They can simulate hypothetical scenarios, reconstruction of scenarios of real events. So, for example, one of the crew members, man, he liked to recreate Spartan Wars, because actually was involved in that time. So he was using the immersion games. In this case, that's how they are called, immersion games, to recreate those scenarios, because they are using your memory banks registry to recreate those scenarios. So he was using that for that. It can be used for training of all kinds. So pilots, professional training. Also for therapeutic use, there are therapeutic uses, as for example, to treat post-traumatic disorder, etc. But now, let me just hear, I'm just going to read this as an example of how technical they are when they describe certain things. So this is how they describe the immersion technology. The signal goes from the immersion chamber or immersion pod to the receiver that has the harmonic energy dynamics that correspond to the frequency of the signal emitted by the pod. Mm-hmm. The signal comes or is read from neuronal activity and its electrochemical magnetic dynamics that interferometer type sensors detect. In other words, this device reads and makes a precise map of all the electrochemical magnetic movements that occur within the brain and transmits it to another receiving brain. The immersion pod detects brain waves and electrochemical magnetic dynamics and retransmits them through muon gravity transmission technology to another brain that is ready to receive the signal. At the same time, two more paragraphs. At the same time, the pod puts the original body in stasis or suspended animation and isolates the information coming from its senses. In other words, the original body remains only as a container for an original brain. Well, I'm going to skip this because, for this to be achieved, it is necessary to have another avatar body on Earth that corresponds in frequencies with that of the original mind of the soul that will carry it. Now, two ways of creating this avatar. This body on Earth is created and inserted into the matrix to be later inhabited by someone else in immersion. Mm-hmm. And this relates to the non-real people, organic portals. In other words, this person can be created and inserted into the matrix. And then you, as you come in from the immersion, you inhabit that entity, that person. Or
hacking an extra people.
Yes, yeah, what? Yes.
We call it hacking extra people, extras from the movies.
Yes, hacking extras, yeah. Yes.
Hacking extras.
Yes. Yes, exactly. Or you choose an avatar, a body that is naturally existing from the source, a real person that has a similar but not the same frequency. That person is taken and its frequency is modified to be able to receive the signal satisfactorily. It doesn't mean that you, as you are immersing yourself, you are invading that person. No, it's more happens as an agreement between souls. So you can this is what the walkings are, the walking souls. You can walk in from the source directly or through the immersion technology. These are also walkings. So as you decide to do this, the soul, the signal of the person that was there, leaves, and then you come in. And for sure, many of your viewers and all the star seeds around the world can relate to some of this, that they feel like something, they walked in at a certain time of their life. And for example, in my case, they told me, because I have no memories, like my memory settings are very low. they told me that I walked in only in 2017. Just before I actually entered into the communication, like I walked in just to do this work. And I started this in 2017 in December, and they told me I walked in on my 40th birthday, which is 21st August. I was 40 in 2017. That's what they told me. And it's very.
Are you just 6 years old then, or
on Earth? Yeah, that's what they told me. I don't have any recollection. I have all my memories from the past. Mm-hmm. Because someone might ask, well, then what were you before? You didn't exist or what? Well, they're not telling me this exactly because they don't want to impose too much on my experience as Gosia from the past. They are very careful with that. Like they don't want to invalidate my experience or validate, because they always try to empower you and make you decide what things mean to you and what life means to you. Because that's an important thing. If you are coming in here, it doesn't mean that your life is not real. It's as real as it is if you were coming from the source. It's just that you are coming using technology, but your experience, even though you have a body up there, your experience as a human is as real and valuable. Mm-hmm. So what I want to say that when I came in 2017, the way I understand is that I don't think I walked into the organic portal. I have a feeling that Gosia existed and she just left. And I downloaded her memories, because that's what happens. When you come into the immersion, You have to be brave in a way, because you have to accept that when you come in, you are going to be fused with that person's field and that person's memories and that person's traumas and psychological issues. Yeah, you can override it because your entering frequency will be the dominant one now. But in some way, you are still subject to those memories of the past and things like that. So
same feeling that we know we entered later, but this body already existed. It was not projected into the matrix. There was a Shiva before and left. So this is my feeling too.
Mm. We call it tuning into the matrix.
Yeah, yes.
We tuned much later, not from birth, much later.
Yes.
Tuned in. And I have seen in my dreams that my memories has been added to my mind. It's a kind of artificial memory or a kind of memory from the avatar before.
Yes. You know that the memories you have, they are like not fully belong to you.
Correct.
That they belong to the avatar before.
Correct. And a little question to you about your past lives.
Past lives. Okay. Yeah.
Do you have memories?
I'm very bad with that. I don't have memories at all. I might have like impressions and feelings and certain attractions, and you know, something may be pulling me in that direction. Would be the indication of something to do with a past life, but nothing special. Why are you asking?
If you would have memories in past lives, is it the memories of the avatar before?
What do you think?
Yeah.
Let me write that down. I'm going to ask them.
Because we have memories about our past lives.
Same.
And we have the same memories from one life in England. The same memories we can tell us about the memories we have had in old England.
Wow.
It's very interesting. And now we are thinking, when we tuned in, entered the matrix much later, not from birth.
Yeah. Other
whose memories are these?
Ours or
Yeah. It's very interesting. It never occurred to me, but this is my kind of question. I like these kinds of analytical questions. Yes, I'm going to write that down and I will pass it on because it makes sense. If you have a memory of me being living in Poland when I was 5, that belongs to the avatar. So how could I discern and make a differentiation between that kind of memory and a past life memory? How do I know what soul it belongs to?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I think the fact that you are still here and you remember coming from the immersion together, now you are together, you have a past life memory together. I mean, the fact that you chose these avatars and whether now these avatars' memories are of the avatars or of you, I think in the long run doesn't really matter. It still means, it still shows that you have a connection there, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And there is a reason why we choose these specific avatars, because we have a certain frequency match to those specific avatars. So it's not like they are totally disconnected type of people. So there are all kinds of variants also here. There's a variance, phenomenon where we don't exist just in one body. We exist in different variants and avatars. So actually, maybe those avatars could have been even you from another point of attention, because there is no time. And actually, two of you could exist at the same time. Anyway, there are so many possibilities here. I'm just like,
it's crazy. It's crazy.
Going with this.
And that led us thinking maybe we have a kind of cryo program, immersion pod program for some lives. In a row?
Is that possible? That's what we ask us ourselves.
That is what we ask ourselves.
It is possible.
I think we have been here for a few thousand years, like 5,000. Is that possible? Or do you need to go back after every life? Or can you be trapped in the soul light trap? We call it light trap. It was our first video years ago. And that's what we ask ourselves.
I don't know if you know, but apart from my channel, there is also a direct channel made by them just recently, and it's by Mari Swaruu. It's called Swaruu Official. Then the latest one that Zael of Erra published, Zael of Erra, do you know that one, the channel? Mm-hmm. Well, then watch that one, because in that one, the last video where it says what happens after we die, he mentioned some of what you're saying, that sometimes even if you are in the immersion pod, it's rare, but it can happen. All depends on your ideas and your soul intentions. It's all there in the end, no matter what technology. Even if you are in immersion pod, you can actually, I don't like this word trapped, because it's all your soul's intentions in the end. You can get lured, drawn into coming back again. And as he said in this latest video, and you don't wake up in the pod. The way I heard about this, it's not very rare. Normally when you die, you wake up, but it depends on the intensity and strength of your intention. If your soul really has the intention of repeating life or going back again, then it skips, waking up in the pod. And then just, wants to come back. But yes. or maybe you did wake up in the pod, but you just don't remember that part. Yeah. And we went straight back. Oh, yeah, I'll do it again. Let's go. So, and you don't remember.
So I remember on some afterlife, I have some afterlife memories from us together from the last life in England. And then he got switched back to a black funnel. And yeah, was born. So, it's his body, but I don't know. Yeah, we will watch the new video.
Yeah, because it mentioned something. Some of that. I think maybe that your brain that is the one that is, like, interprets the memory. That is not the memory is not in the brain, but it's kind of like the decoder of the memory, or something like that. I don't remember all the details. I think maybe it filters out maybe the part where you are waking up in the pod and decide to come back. So you're skipping that part of the process. Or maybe, like Zael said, you do return right away without waking up in the pod. There are all kinds of cases. There are cases for, I know the case of someone dying in the pod. I know there is someone who was in the immersion and then he died in the pod and no one knows why. And we don't know the story exactly. We don't know. But something happened on the soul level of that person. They decide not to wake up and just transcend. And then there's another crazy possibility. And that Zael mentioned this as well, that, for example, if you are here and you have a body in a 5D pod, okay, normally you wake up. But also what can happen, the soul can fragment, because the soul fragments and fuses all the time. And we're going to have the video about this, about soul fragmentation and fusion. Because in the end, we are all fragmented, one mind, one soul in multiple people. Yeah. So what can happen that when you are in the immersion, the point of attention may decide to do different things. So you remain in 3D and your 5D self wakes up and it creates two different points of attention. It's just nuts, like all these possibilities. In my case, this is another one that I think I have to be crazy up there, like seriously. What I did, actually, that I am running two immersion programs at the same time. So if you are in the immersion pod, you can be in one avatar or multiple avatars at the same time. And they told me that this Gosia avatar is only one of two. I have another one, but they don't want to tell me much about it because supposedly the way I programmed the other one is that I didn't want Gosia to know what my other self is doing. So like there is a secrecy around this, but apparently she's a girl, a young girl that is living in Norway right now. And I must be nuts. Like I created these two separate points of attention incarnations happening at the same time. And soul is the point here is the soul is capable of that. It's capable to manage multi-diversity, multi-selves. And it does, actually. That's what we are. We are multi-dimensional beings, collective beings. We are just having this idea of being a separate entity, but we're not.
Yeah, I know. You have also a few point of attraction bodies here on Earth at the same time. Like
you do?
Four more? I don't know.
Yes, I've seen in my dreams that I have a connection to three different personalities on Earth that are connected with my soul. I think that is these are some kind of projection of my whole self.
Yes.
The whole self is fragmented, like you said, and different timelines and different waves and so on. And that makes it a bit complicated with thinking about the cryopods, the immersion pods.
Yeah.
Because of the memories. No? Which are which memories from whom? No? And mostly I use a special technique. I call it spiritual dissociation, this technique. Mm-hmm. And you can learn to use a dissociation. I think you know dissociation from psychology.
Can you describe a bit more what it does?
While dissociating, you stop every associating that is possible. Formally speaking, this is a technique to stop thinking for a while, totally. Mm-hmm. No thinking, no images in your head, nothing.
Yeah.
And then you come into a dissociation state and you collect energy in this moment, because thinking uses a lot of energy, psychic energy, a lot of, maybe 80% or so. And if you start dissociating, you create a kind of energy collection or collecting. And when you stop thinking after a while again, all the energy comes out and pushes your focus to higher states of consciousness. Now, that's a plan with spiritual dissociation. And this is a technique we use to get informations. You have it much easier by checking.
But I would love to be able to actually get more out of myself too, because in the end, you know, we do have the access to the information, and I get very frustrated actually with not, I I'm not for some reason accessing a lot, even though, as Yasky says, it feels to me like I'm not, but for sure I am, just by feeling the information and being able to talk about it, that's already accessing the understanding of it. But I would like to access more. And what you are saying is very true about thinking and stuff. I think that's one of the reasons why after I do lives, or when I have to respond questions or talk a lot, like even after interviews, I get very tired. Like my mind, I feel so drained of energy because I feel that the thinking took up my resources. And I would love that kind of exercise myself by dissociation. And what I also like about this, I don't know if that's what your technique does, I like the idea of being able to dissociate from ideas about yourself, about your reality, anything, just be totally blank, like detached from what you think forms you and defines you.
Correct. That's the point. And with dissociation, you get into a state where you have no access to your memories from Earth.
Not even your name.
Wow, that's so cool. I would love that.
And then you are open for any beliefs, for any information, for any ability that you can reach, that you can access. Having access to, my English is bad today. It's early in the morning.
No, I completely understand you. And actually, this is something that we talk about with Yasky a lot too. And just recently I was talking about to her how I would like to be able to go beyond the state of my own self-defining perception of self. Like, what is this? I feel like it's limiting me in some way, even though that's maybe another idea that's limiting me. But it's like we are not just this identity, and even our memories and our beliefs, our anything. We're just like field of potential energy. I just want to be that, and I am that. But at the same time, within that, I have formed this node of certain identity. And, you know, Yasky always talks about ideas. It's the what it for, that's what forms your sense of identity, you know. And it's great. You cannot be a person within the physical manifestation of existence without having certain range of ideas, but that's what enables incarnation. That's what it is. But still, I know that deep inside, I am just energy field, you know, and beyond any of these associations. So I like that technique. I think it would help me actually, because I spent too much time thinking and working and at the same time feeling like I'm just. So it's like I always have to be integrating the feeling of myself being a field and having to work within the range of identity to perform this work as a person. So.
Yeah, the matrix is very tricky with memories.
Yes.
Because when I enter a lucid dream or a dream and I start wondering, this is not my house. This is another house. No?
Yes.
And at this moment, suddenly memories come into my mind and tell me, you moved last week. And then you think, yes, I moved last week. This is my new house. No? And that's in the matrix, the same. No?
Yeah.
They can put memories into your mind to justify some things in the present where you maybe wonder about.
Yeah, and we actually made videos about this too, like about memory implants.
Mm-hmm.
We had a video about the etheric implants, artificial implants that the Federation, for example, does, and you know all the negative people are doing that as well. But we as souls are actually doing that to ourselves as well. Like you said, to justify certain context or whatever. And this happens also from the afterlife side. Like, for example, if we want to have a totally different experience somewhere else, maybe it's a different race member. Mm-hmm. But we have never been an Assyrian, for example. I want to be Assyrian now. So I need to like sort of download from the field, from the ether, where everything already exists, a certain context, you know, to kind of understand that Syrian reality. But no one comes to any physical experience without any context whatsoever. There are always associations, like you say, you know, we either implanted ourselves or experience. So we have a video about that if anybody wants to see etheric implants or about the memory. And yeah, it's very complicated and fascinating subject about the memories. Because, for example, you are coming here as from the immersion and you are merging with the memories of that person. And what you experience as that avatar, is that really you? Is it not you? It feels like it's you, but it doesn't feel like it's you. Where is you in this whole process? And yes, he said that even, for example, even if I decide to be extracted, it happens, they extract people. So imagine I go to the ship.
Oh, we are ready to get extracted.
I am not ready yet, but maybe sometime. Yeah. My memories as Gosia, even though I will reactivate my memories of my original 5D me, my memories of Gosia will follow me. Like I'm not able to like disconnect from that avatar's memories. And yes, he said, no, they will always be with you. You just need to integrate it and see it as something enriching, because souls, that's how they are built. They always acquire and, you know, more information, and they're always souls entanglements with other people and stuff like that. So this is how the soul grows, even through acquiring other memories into yourself. It's going to be expanded me now. It's going to be 5D me with 3D memories, even though I haven't lived it. But I have to integrate it into myself. I kind of like ate Gosia's memories. They became me now. Like, she was saying it. It's, I have to see it as enriching, as something enriching.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Yeah. Nice.
Crazy.
Yeah, but it's all very crazy, and we are going into all these directions. Yeah, where this is a fascinating subject for me as well. The memories and what makes up the self and the immersion selves and the 3D avatars and how it works.
It's also very interesting. We have seen a live video in your live stream, and you were talking about a holistic society.
Okay, yeah, okay. Holistic society.
Very interesting, because we live in Paraguay. We have moved from Europe to Paraguay, and we have built a house here. We have a nice garden now, and we live in a pre-holistic society, I would say.
Yeah, our higher selves led us here to stay here.
There are more than 250 settlers here, and they are, the most of them are spiritual and political awake. No?
Awaken.
And it's very interesting to have a spiritual community and to live here in Paraguay. It's much easier to live on this way. And the founder of this community are also very interested in creating a holistic society. Although it's not possible at the moment, because the whole world wants money. No?
It's
not a conventional community. Not everybody is going like this and this. No, it's real spirituality here.
Normal people live here, normal people, but...
In peace.
In peace, and it's very interesting to see. They're very grounded also. No? No one is floating in the sky or something, or levitating. It's really great. And what do you think can help such a community to become more and more holistic?
What would the Swaruu suggest?
Before I answer this, if I can answer, because maybe not easy. What is your community like? Like, are you self-sustained? Do you have access to food that you grow yourselves?
And we have gardens here. We have clear water. We have organic vegetable salads, fruits, everything.
We have an own cafe. We have
a bakery, we have restaurant, we have...
Is it like a little town?
Very little.
It's like a village.
Oh. Yeah, it's an own village. We don't like too many people on one place. So it's a nice... Yeah, you have your privacy, you can do your own stuff, you can grow spiritual. But if you like, you can go to the... Zentrum, to the center of the village, and there you have everything. You have a mini mercado, you have everything.
Wow. And is it far from the normal city, or you were like hidden away?
The next town is also a little town, maybe 8 miles in distance.
You need to go 20 minutes by car,
and the main city is maybe 200 miles.
4 hours.
Yeah.
But I imagine that, let me just ask this like a simple 3D question. I imagine that everybody there is able to sustain themselves. Like financially, they're okay, right? They don't go work in a matrix or anything like that.
Oh, many of them work. They have
work from home, probably, I imagine.
Little company here in Paraguay, or they still have a company in Europe.
Or they create something here to work for the community. Installation of bathrooms like that. Many people use it here because they are building houses and they need an a man who installed passes.
Yeah. But like, for example, if I'm asking because I'm living here with my boyfriend here in Finland, and he's still in the matrix because, you know, he needs to work, he needs money, he goes to school, stuff like that. But I know he's like suffering within this system a lot. So I'm just asking, like, how do people achieve this? So, for example, if anybody wanted to come to your community, how do they get about? How do they have a house? Do they have to build it themselves, or how can they join?
You can rent a house if you like. Yeah, or you build a house if you have the money.
But you have to buy land then, right?
Yeah.
You have to buy a plot.
Yeah. Okay.
Build your house on it.
Yeah. The founder of the EPV, the El Paraíso Verde, is it called? He managed everything. He has teams for building the house. He has team to manage all the gardens and to manage everything. Everything is managed. Even the cedula, the immigration to Paraguay is managed by the founder. So it's like. Wie heißt betreutes Wohnen? It's like when you go for old people and everything is done for them. So
yeah, like a retirement home.
24/7 service.
Yeah, you just need a little money.
It's really great. It's very comfortable here.
Yeah.
And we think it's a great idea to build such a community. And I think it is possible maybe in the future that more and more communities of this kind will be created.
Yeah, many people would love to live in a society that is holistic. I so often, and here is one, it is pre-holistic, very pre-holistic maybe, but...
But it's a start. We are pioneers of a holistic society, so to say.
Like the Taygetan, we loved the videos about how the Taygetan described their holistic society in 5D. Mm-hmm. And yeah, the idea is great. And yeah, it would be great if people could do that on Earth too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm listening with open ears because maybe, I don't know, I'm very open to ideas about my own life. Like, you know, I'm okay here in Finland, but I know he isn't. So I don't know, maybe, who knows, maybe one day I'll be there. I don't know.
You're invited.
We live in front of the forest here. Everything is green. It's like a little peace land.
Yeah.
But you have electricity. Are you in any way connected to the grid or at all off grid?
No, we have both. You can be connected to the grid, but our founder is now switching that everybody is autark, so that like with solar collectors autark.
Mm-hmm.
Water is autark. Okay. We have autark water, so we don't need water from outside. We have our own. Yeah, water from a river deep in the earth.
Yeah. When did this start, this community?
2017.
So when very you recent.
When you
2017.
Yeah.
Interesting, yeah.
2017.
Okay, and what do you think the owner's idea for that village really is? Like, what is his vision long-term?
To create a big community, maybe about 5,000 people at last, and to start the changing of the world from here.
Hmm.
Bill Gates doesn't like us.
No.
Bill Gates has ordered his newspapers to shoot in our direction with his media cannons.
All over the world, you could read bad news about the EPV or the El Paraíso Verde. Nothing was true of that. But all newspapers around the world talk about the EPV.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It was crazy. It was a few months ago just. And yeah. But his vision really is a holistic society, 5,000 people is years in advance. We are now 250 and maybe 1,000 will be in a few years. So it's a small and it will grow.
How many people do you have now?
At all, 250 now. And okay. 50 children and the rest between, in any age, yeah. Sure.
But in a way, I mean, he had to find a place, a big land to host those 5,000 people that he wants.
Yeah, he and his wife, they were led from their higher selves to go to get this land, to find this land. So it's like 16, oh, it's huge. I don't know in English. Yes.
16,000 square kilometers.
No, she's not from USA. It's
in miles.
Kilometers.
You are in kilometers. Okay, yeah, 16 kilometers in square kilometers. It's very, very huge.
No? Yeah.
Do you think his spiritual beliefs? Do you think he believes in extraterrestrials and all that?
Same like us. He knows about the Matrix. Yeah, he knows everything about the Matrix, about the extraterrestrials and the aliens and so
really?
On.
Really? Okay.
But his wife also, mm-hmm. and we also have sometimes conversations, meet together, drink coffee and talk about all this stuff with them together.
Let me ask you this question. If someone who is watching would be interested, what would they have to do to come and check it out and maybe in the future relocate? Like, what's the first step?
Oh, he just can go to the website of the El Paris Verde and fill out a contact form.
And say, hi.
No?
I'm Shiva. I would like to join you. Maybe it's good if you tell a little bit about himself, like what is he doing? Is he spiritual awake? The only thing that is not allowed here, it's not allowed to be, you call it papaya. Nobody with papaya is allowed to come here.
Oh, okay.
Schlumpfung. Also,
we call it smurfing.
Smurfing.
Oh, okay.
For our people, nobody who is smurfed can get into the community. Just not crazy people.
Yeah. What's amazing. But like, I'm asking all these questions, like I'm saying, because I don't know, maybe someday in the future, I might be interested in myself. I don't know. I'm kind of like in this crossroads right now with my boyfriend. But you, like you said, the house is not provided. You have to build your own house, right?
You have to build it or you can rent it. Many people are buying apartments or other houses for people to rent so that people who cannot afford an own house can rent one. You don't have to buy a plot or property to just rent.
Like comparing to Europe rents, sorry, like for the viewers, I'm personally interested, and maybe someone is interested who is watching too. Like maybe. Comparing to Europe, how is it expensive? Comparing to how it is?
The renting is very cheap here. Maybe around, don't know. It's different. It's a matter of the size of the apartment.
Yeah.
It starts with 350 euros, maybe. For rent for two rooms.
And a big house is for 1,500. But food.
Yeah.
Food is very, very, as every other stuff is very, very, very.
But food you only get it from yourself.
Much cheaper.
What?
Pardon?
Yeah. But the food you only get it from yourselves in your own community.
And we have a mini mercado here and they offer their own stuff grown in our own gardens. And from the El Paris Verde, it's a huge garden.
Mm-hmm.
And they also import the good stuff. Good stuff we need to talk about. But you can also go to the next village 20 minutes away. The road isn't very, it's not Na, egal. It's off-road. It's off-road.
It's off-road.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. Okay.
By anything else. So
you can also animals. So there are no limitations except for the papaya thing. You can bring animals.
A peaceful person. So any normal. It's really to be holistic in a way.
You can be here whatever you like.
Yeah. He also, independently
from your belief, independently from your look or something else, that you can be a part of it, or you stay in your on your property and have no contact to anyone.
Okay.
Like, on your own mind.
Our founders always says, "You are creators. Create."
Yeah.
That is the vision of Erwin and Sylvia.
Well, that's important, you know, just in case people might start thinking, you know, it's maybe there's, you know, because this community sometimes maybe they have strange ideas or whatever. So you don't have any practices that you have to go and participate in some kind of
nothing.
Open-minded people. It's not like you're going in the church and every this normality. No. It's really for lovable people, open-minded and not dogmatic.
There is no leader here, nothing.
No.
There is no government here. There is no polis here. It's a constructive kind of anarchy.
Now I'm going to ask, and now I'm going to answer your previous question about the holistic society, but it's good that I asked you this, because now I have an idea and how it relates to the Taygetan societies. But let me ask you this, because in the Taygetan society, and not only Taygetan society, in a lot of advanced extraterrestrial societies, they have these system of councils. So do you have something like that? Like, for example, if there is a problem,
we try to consult at some moment.
Yeah, we have a settler council here.
Yeah.
And everybody can join it.
Everybody can join it.
But you don't need to. It's up to you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let me just maybe talk a little bit about your question that you had about the holistic society and how it can be improved. So what you described, I'm looking at my notes too, because I have my notes about the subject as well. Yeah, it's very much like what they have in Taygetan and other advanced spiritual societies, where we use this word holistic. We used to use the word holographic, but then we decided this is not the right word. So we changed to holistic, which means that includes everybody on equal grounds, including children. Like, for example, in their councils, like you said, anybody is allowed. You don't have to. You can if you want to, including children, because a lot of times children have a lot of insight, especially there, because and when they are 13, more or less, their memory activates of past lives. So they integrate their wisdom of the past lives, and they can bring in a lot of, they can contribute a lot. So it's including everybody on equal ground, integrating a lot of perspectives, allowing a lot of different choices and perspectives and ideas. And yes, it's basically kind of society. Well, there it's different because they don't have money and they don't have economic resources, and everything is kind of provided because they have the technology to create matter from energy. They have replicators at home and all that, so they don't have any lack, and they don't have that.
It's much easier.
So it's easier to for them to be enjoying that system, because there is no scarcity, there is no materialism, no any of that. But now an important thing is that they are very spiritually advanced and ethically advanced. And this is what they told us, that the holistic society here, it cannot be just imposed as some sort of a model from outside. It has to come out naturally from the mentality of the people themselves. So in order for us to be able to manifest that kind of society, we need to work on our spiritual and ethical advancement and expansion, and then that society will naturally come out because it will be reflected to what we are. As they always say, people are not their society. Sorry, people are their society. They don't live in their society. Mm-hmm. Everything on the outside is always like a match to who you are. So yeah. It cannot be imposed, because the moment you impose it, you would destroy the concept. It yeah. has to grow naturally. What do I have here written? One second. So this is the basic of a holistic society, the spiritual and ethical advancement of the people themselves who are generating that society. For example, I was walking down the street with my boyfriend and I see garbage right on the street. Like, why would that person in their head want to throw that on the street and not put it in the bin? So we have to impose the rule. You cannot put it on the street. You have to put it in the bin. But this is common sense. This should be coming naturally from you without anybody telling you. No governments have to tell you, you have to put garbage in the bin. But for some people, if you don't come and tell them what to do, they don't have it naturally. They would just put garbage anywhere. Like, that's what I'm talking about. It has to be something natural. For me, no one has to come and tell me where to put my garbage. It's just...
Maybe that are the Swiss people, I don't know.
Exactly. So here we have that additional element of difficulty. Here we have like soulless matrix people who are always against what we do.
Mm-hmm. Our society are really rare soulless people. Yeah, a lot of people with souls. And that's why it makes it special, because when a lot of people arriving here say, wow, I feel home like very first time in my life. It was with me same. I've never felt home anywhere on this planet. And I have been. Yeah. But here it is like a big family. It's like home. A little bit like home, like, because the energy here is so high. You have a very high level of energy, because here are so many people with souls, and we have like places with high energy here. So yeah, it's like a little bit of 5D here. Everybody, people feel that.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say that you have created this 5D bubble, so to speak, on your house. It manifested out of you, you know. You are, but that's even though implementing a total holistic society on a mass level is not really is not possible yet. They told us that the current mentality of the human consciousness doesn't allow for the true holistic society, like, to be implemented on a global level. But transitional societies are possible. And what you're involved, it sounds to me like one of those transitional societies, 5D bubbles, where...
5D bubble is a great term.
Yeah, really, I love it. 5D
bubble. Yeah. I mean, they always talk about that, like, you yourself have to be your own bubble. Even if you don't live within a community like yours, you live in the middle of a city, be your own 5D bubble, you yourself, you know. Every person is the frequency field to themselves. So carry that and be your own bubble. And then it doesn't even matter if you are on the, you know, where you are on Earth, because the density is your state of mind. So you can be 5D and more anywhere you are. Yeah. But what you are doing is even more powerful, because you are attracting other like-minded people and star seeds, and together you are creating this huge, enormous wave that for sure, you know, is affecting their surroundings and mm-hmm. and everybody there. So what you're doing, yeah, they did mention the transitional societies, that's how it's done, and also that the current level of the society doesn't allow for the global holistic society, but they did mention that and why it's not allowed, and why it's not possible to implement that yet, because the humans are still in their vicious circles of scarcity and determinism and materialism and all that. So they told us that they see the need of non-human mentors trying to help people out of that vicious circle. But now, those non-human mentors, I don't mean them coming directly and, you know, guiding us. This can be done under the table in the form of starseeds, for example. That's what we are. We are those mentors. We are that help. We are that extraterrestrial help coming in and trying to bring people out of their loops and, you know, create that frequency bubble growing and growing and growing. So it becomes like a dominant frequency on Earth. And what else? So yeah, so we are that help under the table. That's what they told us, because they're not going to come down to save us openly. It's not how it's going to work. We are that help, the starseeds and the starseeds communities.
Everyone has his self-responsibility. No?
Yes.
Yeah,
exactly. How it works in their society is that, like you, they kind of contribute with their own skills. So they, if someone wants, likes to build houses, when they help, you know, in the community to build the house, maybe someone else likes to sew clothes because they don't have factories. They don't have, like, you know, these, you know, high, what's the word? You know, when they do a lot of, Yeah, because the audio sometimes, if I speak, I cannot hear you, and I think it's the reverse as well.
Okay.
Yeah, I can hear your mouth move, but I don't know what you're saying. So they don't have these high producing factories, you know, they don't have that. They do everything by their own hands, all replicated, and they appreciate the simple and artistic. Handmade very much. So they are like going back to that because they have achieved such a level of technological advancement that now they are going back to appreciate the simple. And there are a lot of artists there who make clothes, for example, and they share within the community. And maybe someone else likes to make children toys. So they do that. So it's not like you go to the store and you pick what you want, you know, there's no money, nothing like that. They might have something like catalogs, maybe there are a lot of people in the community who make toys. Okay, so they have like a catalog, something like an internet, but, you know, their version. And then you choose, and then you contribute something else. But hey, it's important to note too that it's not obliged to contribute. Like, you don't have to. It's a kind of like what you said, you can participate in your community life, or you don't have to. You can be separate. You can live in isolation because, you know, you that's how you want it to be. So that's how they are as well. No one is coming to force you. Okay, you have to contribute now. You know, no one is there policing your actions. It actually kind of, like I said in the beginning, comes out naturally. Like, everybody just feels this, you know, and they want to contribute because they enjoy it. Another important point that they mentioned with the topic of holistic society is that service to others. So in their society, naturally, they have that service to others, even though they also have service to self. It has to be in balance. But here, as they said, that's why it's important to it's impossible to bring that element into Earth, holistic to service to others mentality, because our planet is not based on that. It's based on everybody is taking care of themselves and their needs and survival mode and deterministic. So that's what they said. This is an example of how it's impossible to bring one of the elements of their system into another planet where the conditions are not there yet to accept that element, because what will happen is that the person will end up being exploited. If you just come with a service to others, you will be just taking advantage of here.
Correct.
On this planet, because the system is not built to integrate that mentality. So in their planet, everybody is in that service to others. So it works. But here, it's not going to work because you will be just exploited in the end by someone along the way. So that's why they said it's not about them coming and imposing a model. It's about changing the consciousness and ethical and spiritual state of the people first. It has to come out naturally. The system will be a match to how you are.
So here,
it cannot be any other way.
Here it is implemented, service to others. Some people are helping to plant trees or helping in the garden and something like that, or creating stuff for other people, making ghee or making other stuff for people. So here, yeah. It's implemented. Yeah.
Well, it sounds good. It sounds like definitely a little piece of holistic society on Earth. And you are doing it because you remember that's how it's done. Mm-hmm. And you are importing that to Earth. Yeah. And that's awesome. That's beautiful. That's how we are changing this planet, by importing these star seeds frequencies, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Showing people how it's done. Yeah. Hey, do you have any pictures on your Facebook or from that area?
Yeah, sure. On the website? Yeah, we are managing the website of the EPV. We can send you the website.
Yeah, send me the link so I can just check it out.
And we have a YouTube channel. We are doing every week YouTube videos from this project. So you can.
Okay. I'll see.
Meet our people, meet the founders, everything.
Yeah. I am not a community person in general. You know, I've always said that. But the way you describe it, it sounds nice.
Different because you can be isolated. I love isolation. And really, I don't like other people. I like other people, but I don't live in cities where are too many people. But now we have our small place to be in isolation. And if we like to, we can go to the community and talk to them, help. And so it's not, same with you. When you talk about that in your videos, that you don't like too many people and like to be isolated, I think, yeah, same with me. But here it is, you can help that. You can be isolated and can be part of the community. So
that's nice. Yeah.
And it's nice to talk to people here who are on the same level. Talk about the same topics. So that's the nice part of the community.
So they almost all of them, like, they embrace the extraterrestrial reality thing, or they're like, okay, really?
So
doubt about, is the Earth flat? Is the Earth round? What is on the moon or inside the moon? Where are the the founders also saw like spaceships or beings from inner Earth here in our community. So they are very open-minded, most of the people,
Wow. Well, I congratulate you on this life decision. It sounds like, and you seem very harmonious and at peace living there. Okay, so
Cabal doesn't like us.
No, not at all.
Not at all.
Of course, it doesn't like starseeds at all. And it has to do with the veganism as well. How it's actually the veganism. You know, it abuses starseeds' sentimental memories of how it is back at home, and they are bringing that here. You know, thinking that's the way. Well, that's the way for you there, but
That's good. You need to keep that for the next time.
I have it written down.
I love it. This argument, right?
Yeah.
This is a good argument, yeah. And then the Cabal uses starseeds, their own memories against them to annihilate them. It's the genocide, what they are doing. And and veganism is only one of those agendas. It's like there are many working together.
Gosia, it was a nice talk to you. We had a lot of fun. And hopefully we will meet another time. I know we have another topic or a few more topics we would like to talk or share about. And maybe we can meet again.
It was really a great interview. We had a lot of fun and it's very interesting. And you are a great person.
Yeah, very authentic.
I think they have been chosen the right person for the mission that you have.
Yeah.
In every case, and we also say greetings to the Swaruus. Thank you for the information they give, and that you help, that we can get the information too. And all the best to you and to the Swaruus. And we keep in contact, I hope.
Yeah.
Would be nice. Thank you very much for the invitation again. And I had a lot of fun too, and looking forward to talking about this next subject. Do you want to mention what the subject will be?
It's about veganism and what it is really about.
Okay.
I don't know.
I never talked about this in any interview or chat with anybody. So this is going
to
be really cool.
Nobody wants to hear it.
No.
No, I know. No one wants to touch the subject. It's very delicate, but we will. We will.
Okay,
so good. Thank you again. Enjoy your day there. What time do you have now?
Oh, 11 in the morning.
Oh, okay. I have 6:10 p.m. So your day is just beginning. Enjoy your day. And thank you again. And hello to all you viewers. And my channel is Cosmic Agency on YouTube.
Put it on.
Oh, Spanish. Agencia Paraguay. They again mentioned Spanish.
Paraguay is Spanish speaking land.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you. And I'll see you next time.
Yeah. Have a nice evening and a good walk with Bongo.
Yes, I'll be going just now. How do you know?
Great.
Okay.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.